sink.
Perfect. Good enough.
He clapped.
We can kind of see each other.
I just want to clap my cheeks now.
Snap reference. Okay, welcome to the first podcast here on Dylan Does Life. The DDL cast. This episode is going to be called the Core 4, and we'll get into why.
I thought that was the name of the podcast.
No, just this one, this episode.
Ooh, I kind of like the Core the DDL, 4 for the name.
But my vote
is still for the Hey Ya, My Outcast.
That's fine. Just the DDL cast, I like that too. But this episode is going to be called
Are you going to try and force the funny this whole time with your stupid radio voice? I'm not going to handle it.
What do you mean? I'm just talking. Relax.
I'm not going to relax.
All right.
I think Jared forces the funny by trying to act Dylan if he's forcing the funny. Either way, I don't force the funny. So.
Yeah, okay. All
right. So on this podcast, we've known each other the longest. We're kind of like the core of all the friend groups that you've seen in all the vlogs in season 1 and season 2. So we're just going to talk about just, I don't know, how we met and just go through the years, I guess, right?
Sure.
How did it go?
You two met, and then we met, and then they met.
Yeah.
That's true, and then we met.
Yeah. Oh, then we met. Then you met.
Okay, hold on. We're gonna rewrite.
Are we in the Matrix? What is going on?
So, first day of kindergarten, we met on the school bus, literally the first day. Miss Osterly was our teacher. I remember that. That was awesome. I remember she had remember that big cow stuffed animal in the tent, or is that just me?
Yeah.
That was awesome.
It was reading time, and if you were a good student, you got to read in the tent.
Exactly. That was awesome. Ooh.
Is that how you guys met?
That is how we met, actually.
Were you guys tent pals?
Were you tent pals?
I don't remember that. That
was
detail.
17 years ago.
But first
Damn,
day.
Damn, that's a long time ago.
Yeah. Oh, shit, we're kind of old. Yeah. But, first day, sat down and then went down the street because we lived close to each other. We still live close, but we were on the same street at the time. And sat down, Connor got right next to me. I was like, you in Miss Osterly's class? And you were like, yeah, and then you punched me in the face.
Yo, word, way to assert your dominance, Alpha.
How did that even happen? I just remember being hit. Do you know?
No.
You're probably a fucking loser.
Just a quick.
Were you wearing a Hawaiian shirt?
No. That trend didn't start for
a few years ago. That's why I punched you in the face.
Yo, Connor service dominance on day one. And then you two, man.
Me and Jared met on the bus, actually.
Hell yeah.
Did we just
really?
Sit next to each other?
In copiers.
Probably. Yo.
Relax. Yeah,
Ricky
so
was
no.
born first, so I don't
it's
hear
true.
About it.
Yeah, you guys
Ricky,
copied me.
Ricky the oldest?
Who got on the bus first?
Me.
Me.
I mean, time-wise, what time did the bus pick you up in kindergarten?
I don't know. I was on the bus with the wheelchair kid. Get away from him.
All right, so I sat next to Jared. We became friends on the bus. And I took a Yu-Gi-Oh! Calculator that I had in my bag, and I was like, yo, write your number on this.
So he
typed out his phone number on my Yu-Gi-Oh! Calculator, and I gave it to my mom, because this was like 4 months of us like talking on the bus. I was like, Mom, this kid's coming to my birthday party.
No, I totally crashed your birthday party.
Water wench, where's the water?
You forgot the water. That was your one job. You got a blanket and
forgot
the water.
She was supposed to get us water.
Right,
she came down with
the
blanket
water?
For herself.
I'm
going
to
go
to the shop.
I don't care about the water. What glasses are you talking about?
Just any glass.
Any glass.
So you went up to Jared?
So,
nope.
Yeah, so I was like, Mom, wait, this is my birthday party. And my mom was like, no. And then my birthday rolled around. And here comes Mrs. Donna and Jared rolling up. And I'm like, Jared! And I ran up, I gave him a hug.
Hell yeah.
We're still friends now.
Oh, yeah. I got a funny story about the first time I introduced my dad to Connor.
Well, how did you guys meet?
Yeah, all right, let's start there.
First grade. We hated each other.
Yeah, we didn't like each other.
Really?
I called his mom stupid or something. I didn't even know his mother at the time. Then I gave him $1 for an ice cream, and we were friends ever since.
At the lunch line?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We were at the Scholastic Book Fair, and I was like, yo, you got to see my friend Connor, Dad. And I went and showed him, and he thought Connor had Down syndrome.
Wait, how?
So he's like, are you fucking kidding me? Oh, where's my fucking son, Mr. Do-Gooder? But yeah, no, it's a pretty rad friendship. We've known each other for like 15 years.
Long ass time.
Too long. Yeah. It's all too long.
Yo, we're actually all just not going to be friends after this podcast.
I hope we are.
Jeez. That's what I'm doing. The
podcast. He'll run out of content real fast.
Riley, don't give me some water. I don't know.
Yeah, get a little parched here. One sip.
I got a claw.
There you go.
I don't like
this. This video is sponsored by Blue Light Lime.
Blue Light Lime, Buster ass cousin to Bud Light Lime.
I like Bud Light Lime better. Sorry, Blue Light. Sorry, I love that.
Blue Light Lime came out first.
I don't care. So like Bud Light Lime.
And then
I know.
Okay.
Before we get too off topic. So it was then you two. And then so we met first.
So
you two.
Then who joined Boy Scouts?
I was.
We were all in Boy Scouts.
No shit. Who started it?
Connor.
Because Connor's definitely
his
Boy
dad
Scouts
was
first.
The leader.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pack leader Sean.
Yeah.
That was fun. We made Stanley Cups that one time.
That's the only thing I remember from Boy Scouts.
Same.
I remember making cars too.
The only thing I remember from Boy Scouts, this is what actually made me quit. There was like one camp trip that we took and it just poured, woke up super wet, and Josh Booker would not shut up. Didn't he like threaten you or some shit?
No, there was this really scary. I went, like, you guys left after Cub Scouts. I stuck it out for Boy Scouts.
Gotcha.
And during Boy Scouts, there's this big scary kid and he said he was going to kill me in my sleep with a guitar string. So I was like, yeah, dude, I'm
Jared
fucking
paced out after that. Holy shit.
Oh, there's the troop. There's the old troop right there.
Troop 409. So rep.
So Boy Scouts is basically how we all got connected then.
Yeah. I mean,
generally?
Yeah, sure.
Actually, isn't there a funny story of you two, Jared and Connor, before you guys actually met, there's a photo.
Oh, yeah, I got a photo.
Oh, yeah, there's a photo of us at a tractor pull.
Yeah, it's me and my mom. We took a photo. We're, like, 4 years old, and there's little Connor riding a tractor in the background. And
before they
knew
each other.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's funny.
It's kind of crazy.
That. Yeah, it's weird.
It's funny
how things
happens.
Work out.
Yeah.
Jeez, man. And then, I don't know, do we even want to talk about the middle school phases?
Dude, that is
I
the
feel
best
like we gotta bring
shit
it up.
Ever. The I was the most ugly phases. Fucking middle schooler ever. It was hysterical.
Dude, I gotta find a photo.
I had, like, the fucking fro.
Do you have your old yearbook photos from when you had the fro?
I might have a picture on my phone.
You can just send it to
send it to me. I'll
you can
it
throw
in.
It up on the...
Alright, yeah, we'll talk business later.
We got some white wall up here. I can probably put it on.
You should just make the background
God,
face.
Middle school days. Those are...
That's shout out to Sam Glaze.
Did we all go on the DC trip?
Fucked up both.
Yeah,
Jared didn't go on the
you
DC
didn't go
trip.
DC
trip?
Nah, dude.
Did we? I was
he put $1,000 right? towards a car, and that really did him well.
Yeah. Wait, that's what you did in some of the DC
of my,
trip?
Yeah.
Jared's put a total of 27 miles on the Lincoln since he got the car.
Oh.
Nah, that trip was.
No, that was fun.
It was a fun trip. That mall that we went to.
We stayed together, right?
Yeah.
It was me, you, Kaz, and Tom Arcuri.
Who was the kid who broke his, like, freshly bought iPod Touch? Who, like, dropped it and just shattered it? What was that kid's name?
Oh,
you know what I'm talking about.
Someone did because they're like, my mom just bought that
kid. He's a fucking weird kid. What was his name?
Was it Dimitri?
No.
Oh, Schneider?
No.
No, it wasn't that kid. It was some fucking kid.
It was somebody.
Riley with shit. The hookup.
Ooh, Bert.
Is that a whole bowl?
Ass bowl
is a whole bowl of water.
Who's turning into the
it's
dog?
A
oh.
Oh.
Okay.
It looked like a bowl.
I'll take the bowl of water.
That would be a decent cereal bowl. Thank you.
No, and that's too small.
Who was that kid, man? I remember someone told he just had like the look of disappointment in his face.
Did he break the iPod Shuffle or something? What was it?
What? An iPod
oh,
Touch?
Oh shit,
Touch, no.
Don't worry.
Ooh. Remember we went to Darien Lake once and I won the iPod Shuffle in that claw machine? You guys remember that? Was that
yeah,
that?
I remember.
I actually
I
do
was
remember
there,
that.
Yeah,
crazy.
Yeah.
That was my proudest
Still,
claw
I
machine moment ever.
Going to Darien Lake.
Went to Darien Lake for Jared's birthday party and forgot Jared.
Yeah, you guys.
We went to Darien Lake, which is amusement park, Six Flags. Went to Darien Lake for Jared's birthday, and we had two cars going, and both of us thought the other car had grabbed Jared, and we realized when we got there that we just didn't invite Jared.
Yeah, you guys suck.
That is horrible.
It's yeah, but it's funny.
That's
oh, it's so funny now.
At least you know we were thinking about you.
Yep, skiddly fog.
Did he show up? I don't even remember.
No,
to be honest. He didn't go.
He had no idea you guys were there.
He had no idea. It wasn't like on his birthday.
Yeah. For his birthday.
It was like the weekend before. Following or before.
Yeah, it was before.
All depending on how Jared's birthday worked out. I remember when we were younger, it'd always get all screwed up because Mother's Day would be like the next day.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's close.
May 9th, guys, mark your calendars.
Yeah, send him stuff.
Yeah. So we had the DC trip. Dated Sarah on that trip.
You know, I think there's some people whose last names you probably just shouldn't put on this because they just probably don't want to be associated with you.
Yeah, that's probably true. You should bleep out some last names.
Yeah, I'll bleep out the last names. First go a little rough, but you know we're going.
Oh, what else happened?
Learning.
This is a.
What else happened in middle school days?
Nothing.
Frank Young
got picked on a lot.
Kids were douchebags in middle school, man.
I didn't get picked on.
I don't remember.
You guys weren't fat. We were fat.
I had long ass hair.
Well, we still are fat.
So did you.
Everyone had sweet hair though. That was the only thing you probably didn't get picked on for.
We played volleyball together in middle school.
We're not bringing this up, Rick.
Why? Oh, no, because I was thinking about a picture. I was not going to bring up how I started over you in volleyball, Dylan.
Yeah, there it is. He did not start over me.
Was I on the court when the game started? On the court when the game started?
Oh my god, it's middle school.
We're done.
Would your parents pay more money to sign you up or something?
Yes, he was on the court.
Lori Loughlin.
I was not on the court yet.
But you see, there's a starting lineup. Not a starting lineup.
I don't know. Dill's just a finisher.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Rick was on the B team, bro.
I don't know, though.
The one rotation.
I wasn't a B team most of the time. I only played one, like, A team game. I started with Dylan during it.
That was Frank Young's
game. Well, they're stupid. Yeah.
That was middle school, right?
First rip off Sweet Easy. Frank Young's.
Don't give Frank Young some traction. He's going to hear that.
Yeah, dude. Bleep out the last.
Frank Young. So are you kidding me? The public roller rink.
You guys want to start up a team?
Kind of.
Right now.
Yeah, dude.
I want to join a beer league team. Can we join a beer league team?
Beer league team would be fun.
No, I was referring to the DMs he sends to me.
Oh.
Is he still?
No. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Every time I check Facebook, I get a DM from Frank Young.
Dude, saying,
you guys want to play on Wednesday nights? You got four hockey league going.
Man. Every time we like my playlist comes up in the car, there's like a few songs. What's going on over there?
He just looked at you like, oh my god.
Yeah, what was I saying? The playlist is always...
I thought you were doing ASMR. I brought
some
water.
Fuck.
What? You brought us water because you thought we were doing ASMR? Just
the water ASMR.
Yeah, when you slurp out of it, I was thinking you straws.
ASMR. I don't fucking know.
What did you say? 9/11 was an inside job.
Yes, he did.
The ASMR that people want.
Joe Biden.
Now that took us completely off track.
This just turned into a conspiracy channel real fast.
Right. What were we talking
Shane
about?
Shane Dawson.
Were we still on Frank Young's? You're moving from Frank Young's?
Bane Charleston. Yeah, let's join a beer league team.
Really? Volleyball
That's
or
expensive.
Hockey?
Well,
we could volleyball.
They would both be cool.
I just want to like rent ice and play a game of hockey.
That'd be fun.
It's like $100 some an hour.
It's yeah, but we can get an actual like 11 or 12 people based on if we want to have one or two goalies and just split it.
Yeah, there were how many years do we were was it Dipping Dots Spring House when we were all on the same team?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool. I was on the C line with Jared, I think.
Me and
we
Connor,
had a power line.
I think we were all on the C line.
No, me and Connor were B-line
defensemen. They were
B-line
defensemen.
Damn. Us busters on the C line.
Hey man, we put in some work, I remember.
There's that one goal or game where I scored 4 goals. I thought I was like the next fucking Wayne Gretzky.
You played hockey the longest, right, Connor?
Yeah, what did Cass
you end up
Chiefs,
until Bantam?
Bro.
Is it?
I played till I was 17.
Whatever that is. Yeah. I dropped out before.
Until you got rocked on the boards.
Yeah, I quit hockey because I was the only one that had to have their mom come in Tyler skates. And I was embarrassed. So I quit.
No. Rick.
I don't remember why I quit hockey.
Can you tie your skates now?
Yes. That's now good. I can.
I think I quit hockey because the only one who stuck with it was Murph. And I was like, Murph's kind of an asshole. We didn't like each other that much in middle school.
Yeah, it's because you both liked the same girl.
Well, we didn't. Well, I used to live on Michael, and then I moved across the street from you.
Yeah, I didn't close. Yeah, I didn't know you.
But we, like...
I mean, like, I knew you, but, yeah. We weren't close at all.
Still, we were close. We made random crap.
We did. R-Star 51.
I was in random crap, too.
Like, actually, random crap 2 or random crap as well?
I think probably both.
I think just 2.
No, you were in 2.
Just 2. Just in 2.
Yeah, it's an old video. Ricky's old channel.
What?
Stop interrupting.
Why? No,
you're fucking up the flow of our cast, bro.
Do you know what a podcast is, Riley? You never listen to a podcast?
I've never listened to a podcast.
You never listen to a podcast, Riley?
Podcasts are dope. It's good. I like it. Keep going.
Thanks, Riley.
Shout out to Optic Hex for... inspiring us to do a podcast.
I don't know who that is.
That's the homie.
I don't know.
You've heard of Optic.
Hector Rodriguez.
Oh, of course I know his full name.
The original COD sniper.
What are
you
doing?
Reaching for my dick.
No, talking about how we met. You ended with middle school. Next comes high school.
Alright, I guess we're
going. Wow, high school. High school.
Transitioning on to high school. I loved high school.
Oh, remember Earth Science? Earth Science sucked.
Earth Science, dude, the carrot story.
That guy was a fucking asshole. Mr. Botticelli. If you're watching this for whatever reason, Mr. Botticelli, I'm just kidding.
Oh my god.
No, he's a piece of shit.
There's gonna be so much that you have to cut out in this because of Jared.
Cut podcasts.
Yeah, well, you're gonna have to cut a lot. A lot of Jared.
Sorry.
You're a liability.
You are a liability.
Mr. Botticelli
sucks. The Core 3 coming to you, episode 2.
It's okay, it's the first go. We'll have more.
Oh, Mr. Botticelli sucks.
I didn't hate him. But, dude, there's...
Dude, I had pneumonia for like 2 weeks.
Connor, remember?
And I came back, and he made me take this test on whatever fucking unit it was.
Rocks.
And I got like, no, I was good at rocks. It was the only unit I was good at. There's some other one, and he, like, I got like a 40 on the test, and he like announced my grade. He's like, Jared fucking sucked on this test. I was like, you suck, man. I was out for 2 weeks.
Do you remember Mrs. Violante?
I've never heard of that teacher ever.
It was Connor's middle school band teacher. No, the middle school band teacher, though. It was me and you that got paired up to play in a song together, and we did not learn a single note of the bells at all. And during the actual performance, like, we would just kind of like hit the bells extremely lightly. Just like, you could hear that something was happening, but like, you couldn't hear it loud enough to know it was completely wrong.
It was absolutely wrong.
Yeah.
I was in percussion for 6 years and never played the bells once.
Yep, same.
Jared has
I never practiced it.
Mine was
I never learned it.
You played drums for a while though, right?
That's
up until 10th grade or 9th grade?
I played from 3rd grade, and once we got into high school, I tried marching band for 2 weeks.
Oh.
Quit that. That sucked.
I remember that was the most angry I've ever seen your father.
Over something so minuscule, it was ridiculous. And then I proceeded to tell the 9th grade band teacher band is a waste of everyone's time, and I told them I quit.
Oh, I remember your dad was like, you're going down a rough life path because you quit marching band.
He wasn't too happy about that. But
we were in Allegheny, I think.
Turned out all right.
Yeah, it turned out pretty all right. Yeah, I didn't really give teachers too much courtesy on their fucking bullshit. Like when I told the physics teacher I cheated on everything he gave me and I dropped it 2 hours before the midterm.
Oh my god.
I thought that was astronomy.
No, astronomy, I failed the final. Because I came into the class because I dropped physics, told him, I don't need this, and I slept. And I slept, and I slept.
And I slept.
And I slept, and I ate food because the lunch ladies gave me a free lunch when I came back from 3 opens in a row. And I slept, and I failed the final with a 64. And when I asked him why he didn't give me a 65, he said, you know damn well why. And I said, fair enough, see you never. And I graduated.
Graduated.
Remember when we went camping and I got hand, foot, mouth disease?
Which camping? There's a dog hair in this.
Mouth disease?
Yeah, do you remember that? We went to Jellystone.
Oh my god,
I thought you got swine flu.
No, I got hand, foot, mouth.
I was definitely not there.
I forgot that existed.
Yeah.
Dude, I got hand, foot, mouth disease last semester.
Yeah, you did. It's like a child disease.
It is.
Dylan got it in college.
Got it in college.
And our entire... Jake was walking around sanitizing everything at all times. Jake was just sanitizing shit. That was so funny. He'd walk into our room like several times a day and just sanitize the door handles. be like, thanks, Jake.
I really only had hand, foot, though.
I don't know what the mouth no part mouth would be.
What you get mouth you get sores in your mouth.
Yeah, it's gross. It was just hand, foot. It was weird.
You had sores on your hands and feet?
It's like small little blisters.
Yeah. That sucks.
Yeah, it only lasted for like a couple days.
Still got hand, antibiotic foot, and wiener disease.
The candy game.
Fuck. Instruments?
Oh. I played two instruments throughout my school career.
Did you play French horn?
No.
Jared played a trombone for like 8 days.
Wrong. Wrong.
Trumpet.
Ill-informed. The wrong trumpet.
He also tried what? The cello for the cello 6 days?
No, the cello was less than 6 days. They literally called my parents from the school and were like, yeah, maybe this isn't for him.
Tell them the lesson story.
Oh, when I was playing the trumpet?
Yeah.
My teacher was like, okay, go home and learn how to play like the fucking E or whatever. I'm like, all right, whatever, I'll give it a shot. So I go home, I'm not learning how to play the fucking E. So I just took the trumpet and I blew on it and just played with all the little fucking valves that came in. I came in and my teacher was like, did you learn how to play the E? I'm like, no, but I know how to do this. I just blew it up. She's like, all right, this kid's gotta be special. Oh, I did not have a good like music career in school.
Dude, you also have another good chorus story.
Oh, chorus in ninth grade. Mr. Leary, shout out to the homie. He was a cool guy. But we had lessons we had to go to, and I forgot those were a thing. So like three quarters through the semester or whatever, I realized, holy shit, I haven't gone to a single lesson. So I go to Mr. Leary and I'm like, yo, dude, I totally forgot those existed. He's like, yeah, I noticed you have a 40. I'm like,
chorus, bro.
Shit. So he's like, if you come to the rest of your lessons and you whatever you get on the final exam is what I'll give you for your grade.
That's the homie.
And I still think I missed the lesson, and he let me do it anyway.
Jeez, dude.
It's useless.
Just got out of class.
You learn how to go for the whole fucking time. I don't know how to sing.
I did chorus once in fifth grade.
That woman sucked. Mrs. Barrand?
No, that was...
We moved schools in fifth grade.
Fifth grade was Barron.
I was thinking kindergarten.
Remember in third grade when you peed your pants and music and your mom almost got Miss Barron
fired?
Oh,
no, I didn't pee my pants, but I was close to it. I said...
No, you peed your pants on the bus.
In fucking, like, kindergarten, Ricky.
I shit my pants in kindergarten.
I shit myself in my shower, like, 2 years ago.
I shit myself at work this summer.
Out of pocket.
I shit myself at work this summer because Lockport sucks.
He did, dude. Oh, don't even tell it.
Oh, what? Yeah. No, we're in Lockport. I had Tim Hortons for breakfast. It just hits the lower intestines. And I'm trying to go use the bathroom of this weird fucking Christian house we're painting. It's like a ministry, too. I'm knocking on the door. The door is fucking locked. I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to shit my pants. And I sharted a little too hard.
He turns to me and goes, Dylan, you got to take me somewhere, bro. I'm
like, I couldn't
what
move.
He goes, I shit my pants. Booked into the closest Rite Aid. I got flipped off by a family trying to cross the street.
I was calling like 50 and a 20.
Taking Jared to the bathroom.
The Rite Aid down the street. Threw my underwear
comes out with cologne, deodorant. Dude.
And a pack of gum for good measure. But anyway, back to the miss my butthole twitch. But back to the Mrs. Barron story. She sucks too.
I have a story with her as well.
But
weren't you like moving your legs because you had to pee?
It was second grade and I had to piss really, really bad. So I go, Mrs. Barron, can I use the bathroom? And she goes, unless you're on fire or you're bleeding, you can't leave my classroom. So my mom almost got her fired.
One time in fifth grade, it was Miss Barron. That was the OP one, right?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Those little 90-degree plastic chairs.
Yeah.
Those annoying little thing. I was, young. I was just sitting back leaning like this. and I ripped ass, and it echoed through the whole class, dude. I got in so much trouble for that. For farting. Dude, I didn't expect anything. It was just a ricochet off the chair, just a... And I'm, you know, like, fucking 50 pounds. And she's like, dang, I didn't go in the hallway. I'm probably crying. I don't know.
See, I have a story like that, too.
I remember we were in, like, fourth grade, and she had us practice singing the national anthem. Or whatever, and after it, I said, play ball, and she sent me to the principal's office for being
disrespectful. Oh, because that was her thing. That was her thing. She would always tell us, I hate when we go to the sporting events, and after the national anthem, our beautiful song, the people say, play ball. It's the most disrespectful thing ever. You totally did it to be a prick.
Dude, the song's over. It's a new sentence.
You totally did it to be a prick. It's a new thought.
I got a story about farting like that, too. I think it was just second grade, and we were in the middle of math, and I just lifted up my leg and farted as loud as I could.
And just savage.
The entire classroom just started laughing and, like, started a riot in the classroom, and the teacher was just like, guys, it's a natural thing. Everybody farts. It's
okay.
Didn't you have
Mrs. Clothier in fourth grade?
Yeah, but it was second grade.
Oh.
Close.
Damn.
No, I think it was first grade, actually. Like,
didn't we all have the same teacher in first grade? Did everybody have Mrs. LaPenta?
No,
I think I had Mrs. Fallon in first
you
grade.
You and me did.
I thought Tom was in our class, too.
I don't think I was ever in a class with you, Jared. Oh, we were in fifth grade together. Never mind.
Yeah, we missed
Dylan, was I ever in a class with you?
I don't know.
I don't think we were.
First grade. Kindergarten was Miss Foley.
Did you have Miss Foley? Well, we had the same teacher in kindergarten.
Didn't you have Miss Foley?
No. I had Russo, Noe, Kolchak, Drusbeck, Clothier, Wirt.
I thought Drusbeck was third grade.
She moved to... No, I said third grade for Drusbeck.
She moved grades.
Oh, yeah, I forgot kindergarten isn't a thing.
I remember Miss Ryan in fourth grade.
Yeah, you and me and Mrs. Ryan.
Oh, I had Mrs. Ryan, too.
Dude, she told my father that I was useless. It was going nowhere in life. My dad let her have it. I remember that.
Wait, what?
Why?
I'm in fourth grade. I suck at math, dude. But she's like, this kid's going nowhere. I'm like, okay. And then my dad just ripped her.
Still used to be a heavy C student.
Yeah, still used to. Not anymore. What do you
mean? Yeah, not in college.
Not in college. It's what it meant.
Through high school.
Through high school. No, I had a solid
C plus.
I did
B throughout
I did these two's geometry homework every night. That's what we had together. We all had geometry together.
Were you good at math?
Yes. And I would do geometry homework right after school, and I would just take a picture and send it to them every single night. Because they could not do it for their lives.
Funny geometry story, actually.
Oh, proofs? Proofs were a bitch.
Remember, that was a trig.
You guys obviously know.
Proofs were geometry, too.
Oh, you're right. Never mind. Proofs were 100% geometry.
Jesus.
Yeah, I wouldn't know. I didn't take trig, so I wouldn't know what proofs were.
No, I did. Yeah, proofs were my thing, and you guys were like,
you fucking Ricky. The square root of the triangle equals I have no fucking idea.
So one geometry homework assignment, there's like this pack we had to do every week. One time Ricky didn't send it to me for whatever reason, so my dumb ass tried to do it myself, right? And Tom Sion, he was like, yo, you got the homework? I'm like, yeah, but I did it myself and I don't know how to do it. So he copied my homework, granted, and the next day she called me and Tom up to class, but Tom just walked out, and I go up there, she's like, I know you and Tom cheated because the last answer is so beyond wrong. You guys have it so wrong, exactly the same. And so, like, she's like, next class, you and Tom are coming up to me. So next class comes around, and we both go up. She's like, did you guys cheat each other? And Tom just goes, I don't know. Who are you? We just pretended we didn't know each other. I'm like, I don't know, Tom. He's like, I don't know, Dylan. And then we got away with it.
She was a cool chick, though.
She was telling the Costantini story about the paper.
Oh, that's a story.
God.
Were you in that
class? I have a kind of funny story.
No, me and Ricky were in the same English class together.
With Costantini. That dude is the man, but I got a funny story.
Bailey Popovsky?
Well.
Yes.
Oh.
And
Veru.
Yeah, Veru was in it, too.
We were passing letters around the whole class, and then Luke, and then myself, and I had the letter, and there was alright, back to Costantini's story. So a lot of profanity on this. I should probably start over the story a little bit just in case I didn't catch it. Okay, so English class with Mr. Costantini. We're passing around a bunch of notes in class, and then the note got to me. And there's a bunch of profanity on it, and symbols and things I'll not mention. But
watch your profanity.
But Mr. Cosentini came up, kneeled next to my desk, and was like, hand me the note. And I sat there for like 5 seconds, not knowing what to do, and he said it again, and I just fucking ate the note, bro. I shoved that thing in my mouth, and it was just gone. And he literally just sat there like this, looking at me for like 2 minutes, just like, just didn't know what to do. Substitute teacher from God knows where, and he just gave me a pass and told me to walk around the hallway for 15 minutes and then come back. I come back, and like, I come in, he goes, no, another lap. So I made another lap around the third floor, and then came back in.
That guy was something. I love that guy.
The potato.
The potato.
The potato.
Big Irish. Remember guy. Mr. Ferguson's class, Connor?
Yeah.
I was a little tired.
That guy. Mr. Let me teach all my fucking opinions and throw them into the minds of 11th graders. Because I think I matter. Mr. I drive a Triumph because Harleys are too cool.
We had a couple.
Mr. Remember when he said my wife is stronger than me? Yeah.
If I remember Rob's fucking notebook.
Yeah, we had a notebook of all his out-of-pocket quotes.
Let's see if Rob still has that.
He'd quote-unquote grade the packets we did, so we literally said
roasted
Ferguson sucks in the packets, and you'd get 100 on him because he didn't do shit except work on his music.
He did music?
DJ Phoenix?
Wait, what?
Yeah, he was a DJ.
Oh, no.
Like a dubstep DJ.
It was like underground, like hardcore German dubstep that would be on the radio when we walk into class.
On the radio.
Yeah, some people just shouldn't be able to teach children, and that man is one of them.
Remember we like didn't learn anything for the Regents exam because he would like play his scuba diving videos during class?
Glad it didn't happen.
It was just silence. It was just him scuba diving through like Lake Erie like an asshole.
Useless.
The miscellaneous scuba diving.
We watched a video and he tried to tie like monkeys building blocks to Shay's Rebellion, and it was the most out of pocket shit I've ever witnessed in my life.
Oh no.
We learned Shay's Rebellion for probably a good 4 months and it wasn't even on the Regents exam.
That was a real kicker. Not a DBQ, not a question, not a multiple choice
on this question. Nothing.
And I couldn't tell you now what Shay's Rebellion was about.
I know what Shay's Rebellion was about.
I'm going to be a history teacher and I don't even know what the fuck Shay's Rebellion was.
Jared's gonna be like in class about to teach Shay's Rebellion, just be like Googling scuba diving videos.
Scuba diving videos of monkeys with the blocks!
You guys miss high school at all or not really?
It was pretty cool.
I miss
senior year. Senior year was
cool. Senior year was good. Yeah, the senior year was great.
Junior year was pretty shitty.
I enjoyed all years.
I liked junior year. Like
I missed the summers of not having to have a job and being able to do whatever the fuck I wanted. That was awesome.
I missed the summer of 16.
Yeah,
summer 16 was great.
69. That was after senior year, right?
That was the best. Everyone just coasted on their grad money.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I didn't have a job. I couldn't figure out why I didn't have a job then. Yeah, we coasted on our grad money.
Everyone got their graduation money and they just all had jobs, coasted. Oh, I worked at Delta Sonic. I didn't go in.
I worked at
Route 20, Dylan, and I quit because it sucked.
Was I a bad manager?
No, you were great. Ilya just sucked.
That smell.
I didn't even have a grad party. I don't even know how I was coasting. I was just living.
It happens. Did 15?
I think I worked for my dad at that point.
You did work for your dad for a while, or worked for your dad for a while.
I'd like go in like once a month and get paid every week. It's fucking lit.
Dude, there's just so many stories I want to bring up going through my head, but I just don't want to.
Veru's grad party. That was a fucking awesome time.
That was a good. That was the smooth weed.
The smooth weed. Do we want it for the smooth weed story?
Yeah, we can talk about.
I'll shoot the smooth weed story. It's not really much of a story.
It's not really a story at all. It's like the first time me, Connor, and Jared smoked like together at least. I think it might have been like the first or second time.
No, Connor didn't.
Oh, it's self-incriminating.
Yeah, man.
Oh my god.
He smoked a little bit of pot when I was a fucking senior in high school. Get over yourself.
Nah, man, I didn't do that. No, I didn't do that ever. But a lot of people thought I smoked weed a lot.
Yeah.
And I didn't. Mm-hmm. At all. Rarely.
When you're on the football team, you know.
I didn't.
Yeah, when you're a fucking
Yeah, when you're a varsity athlete. Varsity athlete.
Either way,
suffering from concussion syndrome.
Either way, Jared got super, super like.
I didn't get super. Didn't get baked. Super. Baked. I was just hammered when I was smoking.
Yeah, he got pretty crossed, and Jared just came up to me and Connor, which is like, yo, this is some smooth weed. We were like, what? Just start dying laughing. Smooth. Meanwhile, Jared like had just spent 2 hours talking to like 50-year-olds around a fireplace.
No, that was after I got crossed because everyone was going to bed, and I was like, "That was a oh, keep fucking partying."
Connor's grad parties before that, it was also pretty good.
Yeah, the food at your grad party was great.
It was good.
I didn't like it.
It was chivalrous chicken.
I don't really like that kind of shit.
You don't like food? Anything.
Well, I like food.
You don't like you don't good like food.
Burgers. What?
You don't like burgers.
Burgers are good. Yeah,
burgers just kind of slap.
Exactly.
They were like chicken wings and sushi. It tastes like loogies going on your throat. I hate sushi.
It's just not true.
I like sushi.
I like sushi
as well. I like cooked sushi, though. I
don't
like
fucking raw. It's a weird
relationship with sushi.
You don't even like pulled pork.
You don't like pulled pork? I remember.
Where are you getting this from?
I remember Mr. Merlino would take us to the Bills training camp.
I said, oh,
yeah.
You don't like pulled pork? Pulled pork
is all right.
You don't like apple pie?
To eat it.
You don't like turkey?
Yeah, all things I don't really care for.
I don't like apple pie either.
But still, he doesn't delicious. Like turkey.
I like turkey.
Kind of sucks.
Turkey just turkey's doesn't great. Suck.
Pie is yo, underrated. You know what they got at Subway now? Fresh mozzarella.
Jared already hit that up.
No, I didn't.
I thought you got
that. I was going to, but then like, it costs extra.
It does cost. It's like an extra like 80 cents. It's not bad. It's so good. I get it on every time I get a sub now.
You go to Chipotle, slap some guac on that.
I get pepper jack cheese.
It's an extra like dollar. Is that okay?
That's usually what I get.
And well, high school's over, and then we all fucked off to college.
You know, Fat Bob's Kansas barbecue sauce, though?
Shit's good.
Slaps.
Fire. You would enjoy that place.
Probably. I like barbecue.
Yeah.
Brisket's good. It was popping.
I like brisket.
It's a Friday.
Brisket's good.
Brisket's really good.
Do you know where Mother's restaurant is? Downtown?
It's by Allen Street.
Next Connor. Door. Yeah, so then we went to college. Jared, you got all three of you went to ECC.
Right? Yeah, me and
ECC
Connor.
ECC was great.
Me and Connor used to have our little break together.
Community college.
ECC was dumb easy.
Got any stories
ECC
from there?
Was dumb easy. No. From ECC.
Literally not a single
I went
story.
To class, I left.
Was it pretty much
I met some cool people
school,
out of ECC,
like most
though.
People say it is?
Me and Connor used and Rob used to go to Rob's house for our 45-minute break we had on it's Tuesdays and Thursdays.
I used to do Rob's homework for him because he was all busy. He used to pay me.
And then
he paid you.
Yeah. He used to give me like $10. I'd write him like a one-page essay. It's pretty cool.
That was the only one that went to Buff State.
Well, I go to Buff State now. Buff State sucks.
That's why I didn't go to Buff State.
The only cool professor at Buff State is Dr. Steven Peraza. Or no, it's just Steve.
I miss my advisor in the communications department. He was really good. There's I bullshitted through a few classes at Buff State. There was the nutrition class.
I hate you for that so much.
The reason I didn't go, though, because I went to like all my classes except for that one.
That was self-incriminating. Dude. Self-incriminating!
The dude was, like, Chinese or something, and he did...
Why does race matter?
Because he couldn't speak English. I was going to nutrition.
He's like, did you quit you? I'm like, oh, that's bad. That's bad. You shouldn't include that. You what? Just faked a Chinese accent.
I'm not racist. That's just what he sounded like. So I couldn't understand... couldn't understand what he was saying. Like, I'm not going to this class. So I showed up for, like, the midterm and the final... I did all right on those, and I had Dodie write my essay while I was working at
that kid's a fucking boner.
And then, we're not even gonna go to that.
That kid is
not
a chode with glasses.
Homeboy's a boner built like a chode.
Not even going
kid
into that.
Kid is a chode with glasses.
All right. Anyways, yeah, got through that, and then anyway, I was supposed to like fail because of participation because it counted. So I was supposed to get like a 60 and I emailed him. I'm like, listen, man, I was working an overnight job. This was an early class. It started at like 9.
Fucking ass.
I'm like, listen, man, I'm working overnight. I'm transferring schools. Got to save up money. And then he responds in the email. He goes, yeah, no problem, Dylan. Good job. You got a B+ now. I'm like, oh, word, my guy. Thank you.
Hate you for that.
I've done that at Oswego. Not because I, like.
Fuck. You break the chair?
No, I dropped my vape.
Oh.
Want me to get it?
No.
Okay.
Well, yeah. I think this has been a fantastic first episode of the DDL cast.
Yeah, it's also like 2 in the morning. Yeah.
This might be usable. This was just going to be a test run, but I think we might be able to use this.
Yeah, I don't see why you couldn't. Just take out Jared's...
Mr. Botticelli.
Yeah, hopefully just
take out Jared's liabilities.
Hopefully. Well, this was a good practice.
I don't know. Dylan imitated an Asian person. I don't think that's going to go over too well.
Oh, he's got an Asian person.
If you get offended, fuck.
Because he's got a whole Asian community that...
All right, well, I guess we'll have more.
Thanks for stopping by to the Hey Ya by Outkast cast.
Oh, also, you guys are on the same pool table.
Can I get a bleep?
These balls weren't the only things going into a hole. That was out of pocket.
Literally.
Can we get an out-of-pocket counter for Jared during this podcast, too?
We're going to have a tally.
It's like a pitch counter.
Yeah.
I like that. All right, so there'll definitely be more podcasts at some point. More groups, maybe one-on-ones. We'll figure it out. We got a lot of more stories that I wanted to talk about.
One-on-ones.
Blow me.
On the hosting couch.
There's a ton of more stories we have to talk about, too.
There's a ton of more.
Yeah. You were never the best talker.
Who?
You.
Yeah.
You suck.
What I need
you
to be.
Suck at grammar.
Were you in speech?
What?
Were you in AIS? Jared was in AIS math.
I was not in AIS math.
Okay.
I thought you were in AIS math.
No, I had the fucking...
I thought you were in AIS something.
PT.
I was in Spectrum
math. In,
like,
math. Fucking fifth Wi-Fi? Or kindergarten.
What's PT?
Wasn't it called Spectrum?
It was because I was,
whatever,
like, fucking massively tall for my age, and my... body didn't catch up to my my brain didn't catch up to my body, so I was all uncoordinated.
It was at Wyndham. You had like whenever.
Oh, Spectrum classes when you were advanced. Yeah, I was in Spectrum reading.
I was in Spectrum math.
It's also in Spectrum reading.
All right, we're gonna cut this off here. Thank you for watching.
Because Dylan wasn't in Spectrum.
Dylan didn't even know what Spectrum was. He goes the Wi-Fi.
All right.
Goodbye.
Thank you for watching the DDL cast.
Stopping by the Hey Ya by Outkast.
This was the core four. I can't even outro. This was the core four. You can find this podcast only on YouTube. You definitely can't find it on Spotify, Apple Music, or anywhere else.
Why not? Let's mention our sponsors.
I'll work on that. I don't know.
What about like Twitch or something?
Tried, Connor.
I don't know.
All right, thank you.
You subscribe. Can, however, get it on Mixer.
Oh, yeah, didn't Ninja transfer to Mixer?
He did. I'm proud of you.
Why? For-